Nana said to Bill. So that's what I'm doing.
Oh yeah, okay.
But this sure is gonna take a lot of grist. Looks like you're gonna be busy, John.
Ah! Well, what are you building?
Stairs. They are fairly expensive, actually.
Oh man. I could have warned you about the stairs.
I'll try recouping some of the grist from the catwalk I built earlier.
It keeps happening!
Ah, good. Looks like I can get a refund for earlier allocations.
I told you, Rose! I told you about the stairs!
Okay. Consider me fully briefed on the matter of stairs. Now, if you don't mind, it's hard enough to concentrate on this without immersing ourselves in Strider's non sequitur.
Did you know he thinks puppets are cool? He's so dumb!
Does he?
Okay. Obviously don't have enough grist yet for something that ambitious. But you can get started with something of a foundation for upward construction, at least. John, how about you check the cabinet for imps or other useful items? No imps in here, just a lot of shaving cream. Dads love shaving. It's basically all they do. When they're not baking, that is. You capture log 2 cans of shaving cream just in case. You never know when you'll need to bust out hilarious shaving cream Santa beard to ratchet up your prankster's gambit. Your telescope goes flying out the window. It is suggested that you ride the pogo ride. It's a little cramped in here for any sort of proper reckless pogoing. You just grab it and hang onto it until the right moment presents itself. The towel floats back down onto the rack. The circle of stupidity is now complete. It looks like the imps have taken a shining to the Crookstruder. Crooksite and black goo! Everywhere! But it is suggested that John rides the Slimer Pogo and one-ups that imp! Well, okay, it's not a Slimer Pogo, but you mount it anyway and brandish your deadly armaments. Now, ride your steed to victory! Whoa, this is incredibly dangerous! Okay, let's see how they like the old double barrel leather blood. Oops! Oh shit!
Mr. John, respectfully ask that you please stand up.
Don't move, or the pogo gets it!
Now, sir boy, flee from this boorish rabble post-haste.
Nice abscond, dude! The refrigerator skyrockets up the escher ladder to a new rung! 5-star General Electric, and earns 285 boon dollars. Things are really looking up for this feisty appliance.
Well done, John. Polite congratulations.
For some reason, you feel a sense of positive reinforcement. Wherever that feeling is coming from, it sure is a welcome change from the erratic moods earlier.
Now, my silver fellow, I have a well-mannered query to ask.
I blocked the entrance to the study to give you some space to work with the designix. John, imp's behind you. Should I take care of it? You trapped your PDA again, didn't you? Why did you have to pick up all that stupid shaving cream? So pointless.
John, might I bother you for a can opener?
Oblivious to the commotion behind you, you suddenly find yourself pondering the whereabouts of a can opener. You think there is probably one in the kitchen, but the path is blocked by your refrigerator. John is being completely unresponsive. What the hell is that nincompoop doing? Years in the future, but let's not get totally carried away here. A studious eye darts about a page like a honeybee, gathering the nectar of wisdom.
Typical human. Please. Thank you. You are welcome. Good day. How do you do? Splendid. And you? Gratification. Further courtesy. Favor is mutually curried. elixir known as tea. Absurd vestigial fourth digit is cantilevered. Everyone is polite.
Co-player John assesses environment after transition to medium. Followed by Sprite, sans kernel, prototyped once pre-hatch. Completely useless in this form. Severed from suburban grid, house remains mysteriously powered. Convenience presumably facilitated by game, which perhaps deems navigating a powerless house be a handicap less in keeping with spirit of game's principal statement of challenge. Internet connection remains stable as well. Will likely remain stable until the internet itself is compromised by some external threat. Something like, oh, let's say hackers. Kill monsters, get grist, build onto the house. That's the game. Didn't know what the point of this was at the time. Floundering trial and error on exhibit. Unsuccessful attempt at Tier 2 prototype. Knowing what I know now, I might have avoided using a backbreaking, bad-a-mech, incorrectable jokester's right with antiquated lexicon and racist aphorisms. Either that, or I might have tried harder to succeed. Final screen capture before I lost my internet signal for a time. I don't know what happened thereafter, but when I returned, the car was nowhere to be found, and the driveway plateau was in a state of disrepair. The mysteries. Will they ever cease? Bright prototyped once more with grandmother's remains. She treats John to some helpful exposition in a friendly and maternal, grand-maternal manner. Co-player has displayed inexplicably capricious behavior since arrival. Dress-related? Contracted virus indigenous to realm? It should be noted he was kind of a weird guy anyway. Designics deployed. Still no clue what this does. At mercy of Co-player's foolish prioritization tendencies. Grist payload from slain foe. Whether I deal the damage or the Co-player does, yield the same. Though I have a significant advantage in battle, taking measures into my own hands deprives John of hand-to-hand combat experience, which ostensibly will become more critical later. Building. The point. Building upward. The point sharpened and directed. Ah, steeds, steeds, what steeds? Has the whirlwind a home in your manes? Is there a sensitive ear, alert as a flame in your every fiber? Hearing a familiar song from above, all in one accord you strain your bronze chests and, hooves barely touching the ground, turn into straight lines, cleaving the air, and all inspired by God it rushes on. Yeah, I have no idea what the fuck he's doing here. Another one of these things? Really, Egbert family. Really? A view of his kidnapped father's room. I can't see in here for some reason. Perhaps this is because John himself has never entered the room. It is possible that I can see only, in a sense, what John can see, or has seen already. I have not found the time to discuss this with him yet. If he enters the room, the question may answer itself. Ladders seem to be a bit cheaper than stairs.
Fellow John, it appears we have reached an impasse.
Yes, it seems so.
The opener dilemma remains unsettled, most unfortunately.
It is unfortunate, I guess. What are we talking about again?
But it has been a pleasure nonetheless.
Thanks for the courtesy. It's not really necessary, but thanks anyway.
Oh, but thank you.
Okay.
Thank you so very, very much, dear favorable small primate. I shall take my leave now, John. Until next time.
Wait, where did all this sweet loot come from? Why is there suddenly a crumpled hat on your head?